Nah, you know what? It's just a whole extra board. Nah, it ain't not even a, what to call. It's just, instead of 6 boards, it's 7 boards.
All right, so on the contractor's test, they did ask this question. What is the true width of a 2x4, I believe? So it's technically 2x3.5. In this case, we're using 2x12, so it's technically 2x11.5. That's why you see 7 boards, and it's actually coming out to about 6 feet, 6.5 feet. So that was the math problem for today. I hope everyone is doing well and staying positive. This project took place in Vallejo, California, also known as the V, if you're from the Bay Area. This wall is about 50, 55 feet long, 6.5 feet tall. Average, the footing itself is about 7.5 feet wide, 2 feet thick, all number 6 rebar, 10 inches on center. So it's not really much to us. You guys can check out how we put it together. If you have any questions, any comments, you can leave those down below. If you're in the San Francisco Bay Area, Sacramento area, hit us up. All our information is below. I'm about a week or so out getting estimates back, so we've been pretty busy in the field. So definitely appreciate you guys' patience. Check it out. Any questions, any comments, let me know. Let's get into this video. Again, I hope everyone is doing well, staying positive, hanging around people is positive. And remember, it's cool to ask for help. Let's go. Definitely want to give a shout out to everybody that's following us on Instagram and Twitter. Our following is going up, so definitely appreciate you guys. We had one of our videos on Instagram go somewhat viral, about 500,000 views in about 3 or 4 days. And what else we got? We got about 6,000 likes, 300 comments. Some of the comments was, people hide behind the keyboards. But we are on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. I'm getting that back up and running. LinkedIn, I'm gonna get that back up and running. I am on TikTok, but I try not to go there too much. It's just too much comedy. So definitely appreciate you guys. Continue to enjoy the video. Again, if you got any questions, any comments, leave those down below. Got a bunch of projects coming up, so be on the lookout. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. While you're down there, hit that like button. Definitely appreciate you guys. So this footing again was about 60 feet long, 7.5 feet wide, 24 inches thick. We use number 6 rebar, 10 inches on center. We also have a small keyway towards the front of it, which is about 1x1. Detail is important when it comes to rebar. The inspector will fail you. Also having the right tools such as this rebar bender. And we've also got this rebar cutter. The bender bends up to number 7 and the cutter cuts up to number 8. So you definitely want to have that in your arsenals if you're building these retaining walls. So ideally, I film with multiple cameras to kind of give different angles of the project. And normally when I come to edit, I pick out which one is the best. But with this project, all three of them came out pretty nice. So I am going to do two more videos, one from the left side and one from the right side. It kind of gives you guys a different perspective of us building this retaining wall. I won't be much explanation in that, probably just do some music, but those should be coming out within the next week or so. We also got four or five other videos from the longest concrete retaining wall that I'm also working on. So guys, be sure to subscribe if you haven't. Hit that like button while you're down there. Let's get back into this video.
Deja sacar tu pistola de clavos.
So with this project, it was about 40 yards. We used a 6-sack pea gravel. Once it kind of cures and everything, you get about 3,500 to 4,000 PSI. I've been using it for 20 years, so there's no special science to it. 6-sack pea gravel, 4-inch slump. Shout out to my guy Louise with the concrete pump, always coming through. Appreciate you. If you want to stick around to the end, you're going to see the after pictures of this project here, and we also got a video to it at the end. Now on this one, they used a Santa Fe color, which is part of the Davis color concrete. It's the first time using a color concrete in the actual retaining wall itself. Now the first two trucks were just regular concrete, 2.5 trucks, and then after that we had, I believe, two trucks that was the color. So definitely stick around to the end, check those pictures out. Any questions, any comments, leave those below. Let's get back to it.